Hello everyone. Welcome back to the second part of my video, Building a Wooden Clock. In our first video, we put together several gears, gluing them together on this spindle right here. We probably did about four in total. And I stopped because the next gear is quite complicated and I wanted to make sure that I had enough time to do it. So I'm going to make a video just about this one gear. And this is the gear right here. This is the minute wheel. So the first thing we do is put it on the spindle like this. You'll see it has these six holes, and we need to put these spindles inside of those holes. And we want to glue the end of them very, very lightly, just a very little bit. Evenly distributed around the outside. And then stick it in like that. It doesn't need much at all. So I'm using just regular white school glue. I hope it's going to be strong enough. But I think it should be because I'm actually using these wooden spindles to hold the gears together, so that gives it a great deal of strength. Just by itself. So hopefully that together with the glue will be more than enough. I'm going to make sure these are straight up and down, I'm not leaning too much. So I'm going to use this little tool here. Help me measure the right angles of these pins. Because I know I have other gears to put on top of these. So I want to make sure that they're somewhat straight. Okay. So now we have this large piece here. Let's see what they call it. They call this the ratchet housing. It is going to fit over top of three of these pins. But first, we need to put some glue on it. So, we're going to put glue on this side. that should be good. Now, very carefully place this down over these pins. Just like that. Okay. Wipe my hands off here. Perfect. Push that down. Now, included with this kit is this pencil. And graphite is a wonderful dry lubricant, if that makes sense. It is allows pieces and parts to move freely without being drippy like grease. And it says that I need to cover the inside of this whole area with this pencil. So let's do that. Pins may be in the way a little bit. Because this is going to be a little bit of the mechanism inside of this that is going to make the clock work. Okay, well, seems that my recorder was not working very well. So I think I fixed that problem. Apologize for the sound quality at the beginning of this video. My microphone inside the camera was working, but my external microphone was not. So I'm sure I sound very different now. Back to my old self. This is very awkward. I feel like I'm a kindergartner. Sound of this pencil is nice, not too abrasive. Oops. I'm going to move this glue just for now. Okay, so now we have all of this colored in for all of the places I could reach with a pencil are colored in. I think that should be enough. So we are done for this for now. We'll come back to it in a little bit. The next piece is this right here. Bring our glue back. There we go. And we need to put on these three pins, similar to how we did
with the wheel we just got through doing. Sure, we keep the glue off of there as much as possible. Okay, now the next piece is a spacer here, and this gets glue all around here. Some there, put some there, put a little bit in here, just to be safe. Okay. Now this goes down. Just like that. Off a little bit. Okay, press those down. Make sure it's all very secure. And then we come back to this one. And that fits down inside of there. So you can see this one is quite a bit more complicated than the other gears that we've put together so far. So now we have these three little things that are called pawls, P-A-W-L-S. And they fit in like that. Except I've done this one backwards. This will go in like that. And that makes a lot more sense because now this hook will fit and catch these little on that gear. Okay. I think we saved it. Okay. So now we have this ring. It goes down over top of that, just like that. So let's glue these areas right here. Spin it around. Now this has got to fit each one of these pins. Just like that. So we've created a little box with those mechanisms inside of there. Make sure this all stays loosened up. Now it wants us to cut off the outside pins, but leave the inside pins alone for now. So let's do that. Okay, so now I have trimmed off these pins and sanded this down. And we have another piece to put on top, and that is this cover here. So let's bring our glue back. Getting lots of little pieces all over the place. Okay. And it shows us only putting glue on this area right here. So that is what I will do. Because I don't want to glue this and this together, because this has got to spin freely. Line up these pins. There we go. Now we have three things to do. The first is this string. Make sure I pull out, I don't want to undo the whole thing. And we are going to tie it to one of these pins. Make sure I tie it pretty well. So if it doesn't come undone. That should be good. So now the next thing is this spacer here. So let's put glue on it. Just in this area. Just like that. Okay. And then finally, we have this gear, which goes like that. A little more glue. Sometimes I'm more precise with my glue than other times. Okay. Okay, make sure that stays down. Wipe off some of that glue. So now we see that this middle part spins independently of the outside part, which is pretty cool. Now I need to cut down these three pins. Okay. So now that side is done. I'm going to tuck that up in there. Hopefully that will help keep it from becoming unraveled. And now we need to flip it over. So we have two more little pieces that need glue. Once again, the glue comes back. And we'll put glue here. This will go down, matching up to those markings on the larger wheel. Then we have this little odd-shaped disc with a side chopped out of it. Glue on the outside here. Like that. And this shows this lining up between the 50 and the 40. Like that. Make sure that's the same as the picture. Just in case that matters. Now, that means that this huge monstrosity, it's done, and I can let it dry. You can hear the pieces rattle inside of it. Kind of ticking like a clock, huh? Okay, and we have just a few more pieces to complete this step. This is the palette, it's called, and they want me to apply graphite to these areas right here. It's kind of delicate work, and it's already kind of a burnt wood color, a dark brown, so it's hard to tell. The graphite's a little shiny, so... that helps me see a little bit. Okay. And we'll do this one. Okay, so this goes here. Oops, this gets punched out. There we go. So that goes there. We are going to glue in another pin. Loose. So make sure we get a good amount of glue on it. And this piece, which gets glue around this part. It glues on here. Like that. Okay, then we have this piece, which I want to sand off this little piece here. And this gets a little wooden pin in it. And that gets glued down as well. So I'm going to put some glue on this pin. That was not exactly right, because I do not want glue on the whole pin. I want glue down in here. I do not want this part to have glue on it, because this has to move freely. So. It does not feel like it wants to move freely, does it? Spin it around this. sandpaper here a little bit. Much better. Okay. So I'm going to push this pin down. So that moves kind of freely. So, okay. Well, I know this has not necessarily been the smoothest video I have ever made. Lots of stops and starts and bad audio, but I apologize for that. That is not normally the type of video that I make. But I hope you did enjoy it. And I will have another video out soon with the next step in the clock. I don't know that we'll finish up it in the next video, but we'll come really close. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel. I have many, many, many videos yet to make. Thanks, guys.